the training people here, and at Ashesi, what is it? They talk about liberal arts. What does that mean?
The liberal arts is short form, shorthand for liberal arts and sciences. And it means that you train people to have a breadth of vision, to be able to think critically and analytically, to be able to ask the right questions.
That is the purpose of the training, really, eh?
That is the purpose of the training. And to us, an educated person, someone who's, you know, that is the definition of higher education. You want people who have higher level thinking skills.
Yeah.
And who deeply appreciate their role in society. Mm. When somebody emerges from a university, that person should not just be technically competent in one field. They should have that. But in addition to that, they should have this sense that they are guardians. You know, people throw around this word leaders all the time, and I read the papers, and there are always students from the state university saying, we are the future leaders of this country, and you should therefore invest money in us, and so on and so forth. But if you read the subtext, they seem to have an attitude that the country owes them something as future leaders, right? But actually, they owe the country something as future leaders.
What do they learn? What do they learn? What are these students at Ashesi that you train and prepare for the world? What do they study? Like,
they study philosophy, they study literature, they do a lot of mathematics, they study economics, sociology, of course, business administration, computer science.
That's what those are some of the subjects at Ashesi.
Some of the subjects that they do. We have a leadership seminar series that runs through the 4 years of a student's tenure at Ashesi.
So where are they going? Where are they going? What is their plan? When they finish this, where do they go? Where do Ashesi students go? What are the opportunities for them?
Ashesi students are going to be engaged in Ghana's economy for the most part.
Let's talk about, I don't know whether it's style or whether it is a pedagogy, style of teaching. You know, there's a view that part of the problem we have is that people, even from a very young age, are educated so that they pass exams. You know, it's like a road system, you know.
Right.
You ask children, you know, what is road safety? They say, look left, look right, look left again. You say, what is left? And then they are lost.
Right.
You see, something is happening there that's wrong.
Right.
What about that? Isn't that really the crux of the problem?
It is.
Yeah. How do you deal with a thing like that? How do you overcome that? How do you teach so that people's minds are opened and not sort of just absorbing what the teacher says and repeating it?
Well, first, you have to have the confidence that these kids are very intelligent. You have to communicate that confidence to them. You also have to have a rigorous academic program that demands that they solve problems, that they think critically, that they communicate, that they discuss their ideas, that they work in teams. So if you walk into an Ashesi classroom, David, you won't find a teacher sitting on his table, reading his notes, you know, pausing and having a dictation class, which unfortunately is very prevalent in Ghana's educational system, from primary all the way up through higher ed. What you will find is a class where students have been asked to read ahead of time before they come to class, that they've been given problems to solve, and then you come to class to discuss those problems with your professor. That's a very different way of learning than copying notes and at the end of the semester regurgitating those notes, because you've learned nothing.
What do you mean you've learned nothing? That's interesting. You see, that's what I like. You say they copy notes,
regurgitate and you've learned nothing.
No? You haven't learned when you regurgitate the note?
I have a parrot, okay, I can teach a parrot some English words, and it'll repeat them perfectly. But it doesn't mean that it understands English. That's what I mean.
Good point.
A parrot can learn some English words, but it would not have learned English because it does not understand English.
Patrick, I mean, how do you deal with this then? It means then we must teach the teacher.
Yes.
The educator has become the object of learning.
The educator should be a guide.
But where do we get these educators? You see, so in a way, in order for us, for this to change, there ought to be some attention on the kind of, on the teacher. I mean, that's what I mean. The teaching skill itself has to change.
Yes, the way we train our